Hello,
Mr. Taru.
Okay, today we are going to take a look at graphing exponential functions, and we're going to start off with this parent function of y equals 2 to the x. Okay, so I got a little two-way table here set up. I'm just going to plug in some points and graph it, and then talk about this when we have a picture to look at. Get a little bit of cold, so excuse the throat there. Okay, and that probably will happen over the video. 2 to the negative 1. Okay, so how do you plug in negative 1 as an exponent and deal with that? Well, negative exponents, you know, when you write 2 to the negative 1, that's okay in your work, but as a final answer, we don't like to have negative exponents, and certainly not when we're graphing on the xy axis. So 2 to the negative 1 is going to be 1 over 2. So when I take the value of negative 1 that I'm going to plug into this exponential function, which is in the form of y equals a to the x, your book might have b there or something like that, but it's just a base and the variable is up in the exponent. The x is in the exponent. So 2 to the negative 1 is going to be 1 half. Okay. 2 to the 0 power. Well, 2 to the 0 power is equal to, and anything to the 0 power is equal to 1. Let me go off on a tangent here today and explain why is everything to the 0 power equal to 1. Well, let's take a look at, and I'm going to change the color of chalk here because I'm kind of getting off tangent, but what's x to the 4th divided by, let's say, x to the 1st? Well, we know that as being 4x is on top and 1x on the bottom, that's going to cancel out, giving me x to the 3rd. So we remember that when we divide like bases, we subtract the exponents, right? X to the 4th divided by x to the 1st is x to the 4 minus 1, which is 3. Okay, how's that supposed to prove, or not prove, but show why everything to the 0 power is equal to 1? Well, if I change that 4 to a, or excuse me, that exponent of 1 down here to an exponent of 4, and I say, well, what does this come out to? Well, you know that anything divided by itself is equal to 1. But if I apply the exponent rules that you learned about dividing like bases, when you divide like bases, you subtract the exponents. Well, what's 4 minus 4? 0. And while this certainly does not hold as a proof, it's only an example, I can at least with an example show you that yes, x to the 0 power is equal to 1, and indeed anything to the 0 power is equal to 1. And I like to show that through the division, your exponent rules, when you divide like bases, you subtract the exponents, to kind of give kids at least a concrete example of why we always say anything to the 0 power is 1. And sometimes that just kind of gets left off as, well, just memorize it. And that's not a proof, but at least it's not, it's at least an example. Okay. To the 1st power. 2 to the 1st power is 2, and 2 to the 2nd power is equal to 4. Alright, so we have negative 1 half, it's negative 1, negative 1 half, and I intended on filling up all these tick marks. So negative 1, 1 half is there. 0, 1 is here. 1 comma 2 is over 1 and up 2, so over 1 and up 2. And then finally, 2, 4 is over 2 and up 4. And you kind of start to see this, that would be 5. And you kind of see this curvature starting, but if you're not quite there yet, let's try one more point like 3. 2 to the 3rd power is equal to 8. And we get this exponential curve. It'll look something like that. And we're going to call that kind of like our parent function, because I've got about as easy as a base as I can make with this y equals 2 to the x. So exponential, well, is that exponential growth or is that exponential decay? Well, this is going to be when a is greater than 1, it's going to be growth. And when a is greater than 0 and less than 1, it's going to be decay. Now notice I did not say a is less than 1. When a, the base, is less than 1, it's decay, because you can't have, with exponential functions, you cannot have a base which is negative. So if your base, a value, is greater than 1 like this 2 is, that's growth, and when your base is between 0 and 1, that will be decay. That graph is going to come down to the right, and we'll do that as our last example before I run out of time. Some other facts about this basic exponential growth graph that we just got here is all equations in the form of all exponential equations of y equals a to the x goes through 0, 1. Now I'm kind of hesitating a little bit because I'm about to do some transformations that we've learned earlier about vertical and horizontal and, you know, translations and reflections over the x and y axis. So we're going to change a little bit of this, you know, as we go. But when you're looking at this basic, most basic form of exponential growth, if the base is bigger than 1, or decay, all of those equations will pass if there are no vertical or horizontal translations. They will always pass through the value of 0, 1. Also, let's talk about horizontal asymptotes. All exponential growth and decay problems do have a horizontal asymptote. Now, again, if it's in this most basic form of y equals a to the x, again, growth or decay, they are all going to have a horizontal asymptote of, again, with this very basic form. They're all going to have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0, because this graph is coming down and approaching the y value of 0, or it's approaching the x-axis, in this case, as x goes to negative infinity. So, a little bit about the basic exponential, in this case, growth function. Either growth or decay, they all pass through 0, 1. If there's not been a horizontal or vertical translation, a shift, they all have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0 until there's been that vertical shift. We're going to do one of those examples in just a second. And their domain, this domain is going to be all real numbers. It goes to negative infinity to positive infinity. And the range of your basic exponential function y equals a to the x is going to be, well, what is the lowest y value that this graph includes? Well, it's going down and it's approaching 0. Not going to become 0, but it will approach it. And I'm using interval notation because I use that in my pre-calculus class. If this were an inequality, it'd be y is greater than 0 for the range. Okay, so that's about as much as I can talk about the simple graph of y equals 2 to the x. Now I'm going to leave this up here and erase some of these notes I just talked about. And over here, let's do a couple of quick sketches from what we know about transformations. There is a video about transformations in my file of our library of videos, so if this is too fast, look one of those up. How about y equals 2 to the x minus 2? Well, if you have a plus or minus inside your math function, that's a shift left or right. And you can simply do another t-table to get your own coordinates without knowing that this has a horizontal shift to the right because there's a minus 2 inside the math function. But we now do, so this point is going to get moved to the right two places. This point will get moved to the right two places, again, because of the minus 2 that's inside the math function. To the right two places, to the right two places, to the right two places. And we get a graph that looks something like that for y equals 2 to the x minus 2. Of course, now it's not going to pass through 0, 1. Because I've pushed the parent function to the right two places with the minus 2 that's up in the exponent. If I were to change that to y equals 2 to the x minus 2, so now I'm writing the minus 2 as a constant at the end of the equation, not up in the exponent, not up into the really math function that's in the equation, but as a constant at the end, this is going to be a vertical shift down. So again, see my parent function, y equals 2 to the x, with just a minus 2 at the end, not inside the math function, not inside the exponent. This is going to move the graph down, the white parent function that I've made with my table, down two places. So this point is going to come down to, so here, this point is going to come down two places, this point is going to come down two places, and down two places, and I don't think I'm going to be able to do many more graphs on this grid here, but we've got something that probably looks something like this. Now, look at that yellow line. You see that there? What is the horizontal asymptote of that line? This graph, this yellow graph, is now going to come down and not approach zero like the white one did, but approach the y value of negative 2 because I pushed the graph down two places. So this graph is going to have a domain of all real numbers, or negative infinity to positive infinity. But unlike the original white graph, where the range is from 0 to infinity, the yellow graph is going to have a range of negative 2 to infinity. Okay? So, vertical shift and horizontal shift. What, let's squeeze one more in here before I move on to decay, and say, what would y equal 2 to the negative x look like? Well, if you place a negative in front of your math function, again, we did this with transformations, and in my textbook it was 1.7, but if you start off with a negative leading coefficient, that's a reflection over the x-axis. Well, if you have a negative in front of your x that's inside the math function itself, we're not leading off with negative, but it's 2 to the negative x, that's going to be a reflection around the y-axis. So, again, the white line with this y equals 2 to the negative x, this is going to reflect around the y-axis. So instead of my point being here at negative 1.5, it's going to be at positive 1.5. 0, 1 is still going to be 0, 1. This point is going to reflect over the y-axis and come right here. This point at 2, 4 is going to be negative 2, 4. And this point at 3, 8 is going to be negative 3, 8. And I thought I was going to do a decay one, but I believe I'm going to run out of time. But that kind of is decay. Let's talk about this red line for a second, since I'm not going to be able to actually make a decay graph for you before my time runs out. Why? What's happening here? Why does it look like this graph is going down to the right? This reflection over the y-axis that we get. Well, if I rewrite this equation so that my exponent is no longer negative, don't you get rid of a negative exponent by flipping the base? So this can be rewritten as y equals, okay, the 2 has a negative exponent, so I'm going to take that 2 and move it down to the bottom, or flip the base, and get 1 half to the x. So, I inadvertently actually did a decay question. I have a base that is between 0 and 1, and thus, it is decay. Bam! Woo! All right, go do your homework. I hope this helped graph your exponential functions.